Hello everyone, myself Professor Neha Shamkanta Dikshit. I'm going to explain you today's topic, that is the non-conventional machining techniques, and that comes under the unit number 3 from advanced manufacturing process, and the title of the unit number 3 is hybrid non-conventional machining techniques. In this unit, that is hybrid non-conventional machining techniques, we are going to see the following processes. First one is the shape tube electrolytic machining. In short form, it is also known as the STEM, electrochemical grinding, ECG, electrochemical deburring, ECDE, electrolytic in-process dressing, ELPD, electrojet machining, EJM, laser surface treatment, abrasive flow finishing, AFF, magnetic abrasive finishing, MAF, abrasive water jet machining, AWJM, wire electric discharge machining, WEDM, electrochemical discharge machining, ECDM, ultrasonic assisted EDM, that is electrochemical discharge machining, and rotary EDM, that is rotary electrochemical discharge machining. These are the several types of non-conventional machining processes, and even more than two non-conventional machining processes are there involved in a particular one process. So it is also known as a hybrid non-conventional machining process. But in this lecture, we are going to see the basic two main processes, first two main processes, that are the shape tube electrolytic machining and electrochemical grinding. Before we go to our main processes, our objectives of these lectures are to understand working principle of shape tube electrolytic machining process, that is STEM, to illustrate working process and process parameter of STEM, to understand and illustrate working process of electrochemical grinding process, that is ECG, and to identify applications of advanced joining processes, and mainly for this lecture for the SPEM, that is shape tube electrolytic machining process, and ECG, that is electrochemical grinding process. So first of all, we will see the introduction to the hybrid process. What is the hybrid process? And regarding that conventional process, we are going to compare these all hybrid processes. Material removal process are required to produce specific work geometry at definite degree of dimensional accuracy. Selection of a material removal process depends upon three main steps, that is complexity of a shape, accuracy required, properties of work material, and various other parameters. Advancement in techniques for material processing, it is possible to manufacture micro features in the product, and which is necessity in day-to-day life. With development in a cutting technology, it is possible to obtain dimensional accuracy in microns and surface finish nanometers. Machining of advanced materials like ceramics, composites is a challenge with the conventional method, but the major limitation, cutting tool which is used to remove the unwanted material from workpiece must be harder than work material, so as to tool is in direct contact with the workpiece. This process are also known as a non-traditional or unconventional machining process or unconventional machining methods, as in such process there is a no direct contact between the tool and workpiece, or there is a minimum contact between the tool and workpiece, and hence there is a no hurdle to requirement than the workpiece. Now, which are the non-conventional material removal processes? We are going to see in this slide. According to the type of energy used for material removal, such methods, it can be grouped into as follows. First one is the mechanical machining process. Name indicates material is removed from the workpiece with the help of mechanical means. In ultrasonic machining, that is USM, abrasive slurry which is set in a vibration is used to remove the material. The jet of abrasive particle mixed in water is used to remove material in abrasive water jet machining, and in water jet machining, a jet of pressurized water is used to remove material. So basically, USM, AWJM and water jet machining process are the type of the mechanical machining processes. Next type, next non-conventional material removal process is the thermal machining process, and these types are according to the type of energy used for material removal. So here the energy used is thermal. Material is removed from the workpiece by melting and vaporization. In electric discharge machining EDM, material is removed by generating plasma work arc between tool and workpiece. In electron beam machining, that is EBM, in laser beam machining, that is LBM, laser and plasma beam in plasma beam machining are used as a tool to remove the material. So EDM, EBM, LBM and PBM, that is the electron beam, plasma beam and laser beam machining process, are the types of the thermal machining processes. Next type is chemical machining. In this, the material is removed with the help of chemical dissolution action, as in chemical machining, that is CHM, or photochemical machining, that is the PSM. Next type is electrochemical machining. In this, energy used is the combination of chemical and electrical energy. So, electrochemical machining is the combination of chemical and electrical energy. The process is removed electrochemical dissolution action. So, the word dissolution, electrochemical dissolution, is important here. Example of such type of process are electrochemical grinding ECG, ECE and shaped tube electrolytic machining. So, in this lecture series, we are going to see these two main processes, that is STEM and ECG, and these are the electrochemical machining, that is the type of energy used is the chemical and electrical energy. So, these are the summary of non-traditional processes. In this, first mechanical, material is removed from workpiece with the help of mechanical means. In that, we already seen the names of some processes, that is AWJM, WJM, USM, IJM, that is abrasive water jet machining, water jet machining, etc. Next type of energy use is the thermal. Material is removed from workpiece by melting and vaporization. So, in that, EDM, EBM, LBM, that is electrode discharge machining, electro beam machining, laser beam machining, plasma beam machining. Next type is chemical. So, next is the hybrid and electrochemical. So, now we are going to see the details about the shaped tube electrolytic machining, that is the STEM, S-T-E-M. STEM is an electrochemical machining process which works on dissolution principle, mainly used to obtain smaller diameter dipole. So, basic application of this shaped tube electrolytic machining is to obtain the smaller diameter dipole. So, point to remember with this statement is STEM is an electrochemical machining process, dissolution principle is used and used to obtain the smaller deep holes. Process commonly used in aerospace industries to drill holes of high aspect ratio, that is length to diameter ratio is maximum and it is up to 300:1 in difficult to cut super alloys. Electric potential difference is applied between anodic workpiece and cathodic tool. This statement I highlighted here because workpiece having the anode charge, that is the positive charge, and tool is having the negative charge, that is the cathodic charge. So, it is every time remember that whenever there is a electrical point of view is there, then a workpiece is having anode and tool is cathode. So, remember this point until and unless I will mention another thing. Anodic workpiece and cathodic tool are flooded with the electrolyte. Generally, acid based electrolyte such as hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid having 10% concentration in water is used. Acid based electrolyte helps in dissolving the reaction products formed during dissolution process and helps in preventing clogging of electrolyte flow path around the electrode. So basically, the two main advantages or uses of the acid base electrolyte is that electrolyte is used to carry the charge flow. So this is the main setup for the STEM process, that is shaped tube electrolyte machining process. I am going to show you some parts of the STEM processes, then detail working is included in the next slide. See here, this is the tool, this is the workpiece. Workpiece having the anodic charge, tool is having the cathodic charge, power supply is there, fan, housing, constant feed of tool is there. Next, constant feed of electrolyte is also there, and for that flow meter, pressure gauge, other supporting tools are there, pump, filter, heat exchanger, and to hold the workpiece fixture is also there. And detail about the workpiece and tool is like here. See, you can see workpiece is having the anode charge, so you can see here the positive sign, and tool is having the cathodic charge, that is the negative sign, and tool is having some insulating coating. Why insulating coating is needed we will see, and electrolyte flow is also there. So we will see the detailed procedure. The tool electrode used in a STEM, that is a shaped tube electrolyte machining process, is hollow shaped tube with insulation coating on all over exterior surface except at the tip of tool. Servo system used to maintain a constant gap between the tool and workpiece. Low voltage up to 5 to 15 volt DC supply is applied across the gap, as higher voltage causes boiling of electrolyte, which eventually damages the electrode coating and hence affect the geometrical and dimensional accuracy. Tool is given with the constant feed value to maintain the constant machining gap. I already told you that is these are the non-conventional technique. There is a minimum or no contact between the workpiece and the tool is there. Generally, feed rate 1.5 mm per minute is used, maximum up to 5 mm per minute. Using STEM process, small holes 0.76 to 1.62 mm in diameter with higher depth to diameter ratio up to 300:1 can be produced in electrically conductive materials. That means suppose 1 times the diameter, then the depth is 300 times. It is difficult to produce such small size and high aspect ratio holes using ECM, that is electrochemical machining, as insoluble precipitates produced during dissolution process obstruct the electrolyte flow path. Pure titanium is used as a tool material to resist acidic attack by electrolytes. So, it is very easy to remember that which tool is used in STM process, pure titanium, because electrolyte is used, and that electrolyte is acidic medium, and to avoid the acidic reaction, pure titanium material is used. An insulating coating is provided on exterior surface of tool, saves the tool from acidic action of electrolyte and eliminates stray cutting at the hole. The overcut and taper are largely minimized using this process in comparison to ECM process. The taper of 0.015 mm per centimeter and surface finish of 0.8 to 3.1 micrometer is obtained using the STEM process. Multiple holes, as many as 200 holes having different shapes and sizes, can be simultaneously produced by using multiple electrodes, that is multiple tools, that is multiple cathode electrodes. STEM being an electrochemical process prevents formation of a micro crack during the process due to absence of a heat affected layer, which is the major defect observed in the EDM, EBM and LBM processes. So, STEM is the beneficial process to prevent the formation of the micro cracks due to absence of a heat affected zone. The machine component used to carry out STEM process are made from the corrosion resistance materials such as stainless steel, ceramics, titanium and plastic, because as electrolyte we are going to use in this process. Now, these are some process parameters in the STEM. I know that there is some limitation to remind this or to remember this process parameter, but when you grasp the process working mechanism, then you can easily remember the things about the process parameter of the stem. Depending upon the diameter of the hole and thickness of the workpiece, values of a different parameters and types of electrolyte is selected. Electrolyte type sulfuric, nitric and hydrochloric acid etc. use, concentration 10 to 20% concentration in water, machining current maximum up to 600 ampere used, temperature 35 to 40 degrees Celsius for sulfuric acid, and suppose other acids are used, then it is kept up to 20 to 25 degrees Celsius, pressure to 70 to 50 kilopascal used, voltage forward 8 to 14 volt and reverse 0.1 to 1 is used, time forward 5 to 7 second and reverse 25 to 77 milliseconds used, feed rate 0.75 to 3 mm per minute feed rate is used. Now, process capabilities we are going to see here. Cluster of hole with different size can be produced with the help of the stem process. Small hole size, which is not possible to produce with the other electrochemical process, can be produced finally with the stem process. Hole size diameter up to 0.5 to 0.6 mm with the maximum aspect ratio 150. Hole tolerance plus minus 0.05 mm for 0.5 mm diameter and plus minus 0.075 mm for 1.5 diameter and plus or minus 0.1 mm for 60 mm diameter tolerance we can get, and for the depth plus or minus 0.05 mm tolerance we can get. Advantages of a stem: smaller size hole as small as 0.76 mm having high aspect ratio, that is diameter to depth, depth to diameter ratio of 300 can be produced. Multiple hole as large as 200 in numbers having different sizes and shapes can be simultaneously drilled with the help of the different cathodes or different tools. Using stem tabulated, that is non-parallel holes on difficult to cut super alloys can be obtained. Blind holes with small size, shape and curve holes as well as micron slots can be easily produced. No recast layer of a metal or metallurgical defects are produced because heat is absent. Stem being an electrochemical process, eliminate recast layer and heat affected layer. Workpiece produced are free from metallurgical defect and micro cracks as normally observed in a thermal processes such as laser beam machining, EDM. Limitations: only applicable to machine electrically conducting and corrosion resistance materials. Because cathode, anode, electrolyte, power supply is used to cut the holes, is used to process the stem process, so it is only applicable for the electrically conducting material. Stem are more suitable to obtain multiple shape and curve hole as process being very slow and not economical to drill a single hole. Process uses acidic electrolytes and hence special environment and corrosion resistance machine components are required. Special care required to dispose hazardous waste, special tooling required. Applications: applicable to drilling small size and deep holes, but now where the small size and deep holes are needed: holes for cooling purpose, fuel nozzles of a gas turbine and jet engine parts, holes where metallurgical defects and micro cracks are not desirable for drilling, initial hole for wire EDM process, holes for difficult to cut super alloys and corrosion resistance low machinability metals, for production of oil holes and in bearings, drilling of a tabulated non-parallel holes in a turbine blades to enhance the heat transfer coefficient. So these are the application of a stems, and in this figure we can see the tabulated cooling holes in a turbine blade is produced with the help of the stem machining process. So this is all about the stem. We are moving forward to the electrochemical grinding. You know the grinding, but now this is the electrochemical grinding. Here electrical and chemical energy is used to grind the component. Electrochemical grinding is a variant process of basic ECM, that is electrochemical machining. It is burr-free and stress-free material removal process. Components grind by ECG are free from thermal residual stresses, burrs and larger heat affected zone. So, the basic concept here We already seen the classification of the machining processes depending upon the energy used, and in STEM and in ECG, in both processes chemical and electrical energy is used. So ultimately heat produced during the machining process is absent. So thermal residual stresses, heat affected zone are absent during this machining process. But dimensional tolerances and good surface finish is obtained by conventional grinding. In ECG process, material removal of electrically conductive material takes place through combined action of a mechanical and electrochemical process. Mechanical process, which is nothing but conventional grinding process, which is in which tiny chips will be removed through scratching. A specially constructed grinding wheel with negatively charged acting as a cathode and positively charged anode is employed in ECG process. So this is the main schematic diagram of the ECG process. This is the front view and this is one is the side view. See, this one is the work feed and this is the grinding wheel with the metallic bond, and some abrasive particles are also attached to this grinding wheel. Similar to the stem, workpiece is having the positive charge, that is it is act as an anode, while tool as a grinding wheel as a tool is act as a cathode. So negative charge is there and electrolyte flow is also there. You can see here there is a no contact between the grinding wheel and workpiece, or you can say that a zero contact. And same here in this side view diagram, you can see the grinding wheel, electrolyte, workpiece as a positive charge and negative to the grinding wheel. This process is similar to the ECM, except that cathode is specially constructed grinding wheel, while in ECM cathodic shape tool like the contour to be machined by ECM. Workpiece and wheel are separated by an electrolyte fluid which is continuously circulated to flush or remove the fine chips of material removed from the workpiece during the process. Diamond or aluminium oxide particles embedded or on grinding wheel, insulating abrasive materials and set with the conductive bonding material. In this process, non-conductive abrasive particles work as a spacer between the anodic workpiece and conductive bond and the wheel. See, the main thing to remember in this slide or in this process is the abrasive particle that already removed from the material, that are the non-conductive, and that non-conductive abrasive particle act as a spacer between the workpiece and wheel. Constant inter-electrode gap is maintained considering the grain size of the abrasive particle. The electrolyte is flushed through this inter-electrode gap. The commutator is an electrolyte spinner having carbon brushes and holds grinding wheel. It receives a negative charge from the DC power supply. The grinding wheel slightly touches the workpiece and electrolyte is supplied onto the grinding wheel near the workpiece. It is thereby result in an electrochemical action. A nozzle similar to one which carries coolant in a conventional grinding process is provided to enable the flow of electrolytic fluid to work tool area. In ECG, machining is taking in a three zone. First zone, material removal is purely due to electrochemical dissolution, so which occurs at the leading edge of the wheel due to contamination of the reaction product. Conductivity of electrolyte reduces, hence lowers the inter-electrode gap, that means workpiece and tool grinding wheel comes nearer as compared to the previous step. Reduction in IEG, that is reduction in inter-electrode gap, result in a contacting of a abrasive particle with the workpiece, and material is also removed by the abrasive action. So basically in zone 1, two actions are taken. First action is the electrochemical dissolution, and second action is abrasion. So material is purely removed firstly due to the electrochemical dissolution with the help of the electrolyte. But what happens, that materials mix with the electrolyte, and that electrolytes gets contaminated, and hence inter electrode gap is there. As inter electrode gap is there, that workpiece and tool comes closer, and that reduction in IEG results in a contacting of that abrasive particles with the workpiece, and material is also removed by the abrasion action. Second zone is the abrasive particles remove material in the form of the chips and also action. So, this electrochemical grinding machine is like this, as shown in a picture, and fully control panel is there, and all machining work is done under this control environment. Process parameters for this ECG process are, that is for the electrochemical grinding process, size of the abrasive particle is about 60 to 320 grit number. Electrolyte used is sodium chloride and sodium nitride. Surface speed of a wheel 20 to 35 meter per second. Gap voltage between anodic workpiece and cathodic grinding wheel is 4 to 40 volt. Current density is up to 120 to 240 ampere per centimeter square. Depth of cut usually less than 2.5 mm. Material mainly removed by electrochemical dissolution, while mechanical grinding is responsible for an additional 5 to 10% of total material removal, but it is with the help of abrasion action. Process characteristics, that are the unique characteristics of particular that process. So, process characteristics of this electrochemical grinding process are, current density has significant effect on a surface finish and material removal rate, that is the MRR. With highest current density, material removal rate and surface finish both improves. Tool feed rate, if selected lower than the required one, resulting in a poor surface finish and large overcut, that is the dimensional accuracy disturbed. If higher value is there, if feed rate selected than the required one, then abrasive particles will permanently detach from the wheel, resulting in an increase in a wheel wear. Higher material removal rate, that is 10 times in a comparison to the conventional grinding on a hard material, is obtained. However, poor tolerances are obtained in the ECG as compared to the conventional grinding. ECG produces very smooth surface. Surface finish obtained in a range of 0.12 to 0.8 micrometer, and surface produces free from the grinding scratch and burrs. ECG is a cold process, hence reduces structural damages, laser distortion and grinding cracks. In conventional grinding process, as very high heat is developed in a cutting zone, in conventional grinding, thin workpiece tend to warp by heat, that is tend to get angle by the heat and pressure and thus affects to achieve the closer tolerance. However, in ECG, there is almost negligible, that is in electrochemical grinding, there is almost negligible contact between workpiece and the wheel, which eliminates and tendency of a workpiece to warp as normally observed when using grinding. Accuracy and surface quality. Traditional grinding removes metal by abrasion, producing tolerance up to plus 0.003 mm. However, conventional grinding creates large amount of heat and stresses that makes grinding of a thin workpiece very difficult. On the other hand, electrochemical grinding under normal condition produces a machining accuracy tolerances in the range of plus or minus 0.025 mm. However, tolerances of plus or minus 0.008 mm can be achieved using ECG under special circumstances. The closer tolerances achieved when using ECG depend upon the current, feed rate, electrolytic flow and metallurgy of the particular workpiece. However, a better surface finish and accuracy, that is the closer dimensional tolerances, is obtained by carrying out the final cutting operation by conventional grinding action. Low voltage when using electrochemical grinding are used to obtain bright surface finish and closer tolerances. Thin material as small as of 1.02 mm can be efficiently grind by using the electrochemical grinding as against the conventional grinding. In conventional grinding, thin workpiece tend to warp, that is tends to tend by the heat and pressure, and thus affects to achieve closer tolerances. However, in electrochemical grinding, there is an almost negligible contact between the workpiece and the wheel, which eliminates the tendency of a workpiece to warp as normally observed when used. Now, process capabilities we are going to see here. Cluster of hole with different size can be produced with the help of the stem process. Small hole size, which is not possible to produce with the other electrochemical process, can be produced finally with the stem process. Hole size diameter up to 0.5 to 0.6 mm with the maximum aspect ratio 150. Hole tolerance plus minus 0.05 mm for 0.5 mm diameter and plus minus 0.075 mm for 1.5 diameter and plus or minus ECG process. So, this is the main schematic diagram of the ECG process. This is the front view and this is one is the side view. See, this one is the work fit and this is the grinding wheel with the metallic bond and some abrasive particles are also attached to this grinding wheel. Similar to the stem, workpiece is having the positive charge, that is it is act as an anode, while tool as a grinding wheel as a tool. ECG. Applications of the ECG: machining difficult to cut super alloys like inconel, niobium and titanium alloys, also sintered carbides and metallic composites. In production of a burr, free sharpening of hypodermic needles, grinding of aerospace, honeycomb metals and grinding of a super alloy turbine blades, tool and cutter sharpening, machining of a thin wall tube, tungsten carbide tool, high strength alloys and fragile parts, reprofiling of a worn locomotive traction motor gears, burr free sharpening of a hypodermic needles, aerospace, honeycomb metals, fragile parts, traction motor gears. For this type of application, ECG process is used, and this is all about the process parameter, working mechanism of stem, that is shaped tube electrolyte machining process, and ECG, that is electrochemical grinding processes, and also we have covered the applications of the both processes. This is all about the shaped tube electrolyte machining stem process and electrochemical grinding process, ECG process. Thank you for the listening. Thank you for the listening. Thank you.